हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ हैव यू बीन? आई नीलोफर मिस वेलकम टू यू मेहदी इंग्लिश स्कूल। एंड विच सब्जेक्ट इज़ माय सब्जेक्ट इज़ मैथमेटिक्स, दैट यू ऑल नो। एंड दिस टुडेज ऑनलाइन लेक्चर इज़ फॉर द क्लास टू। सो आई होप दैट यू ऑल आर रेडी टू अटेंड दिस ऑनलाइन सेशन, राइट? एंड यू ऑल्सो नो दिस थिंग दैट वी ऑलवेज बिगिन आवर लेक्चर विद द क्वाट। So here is the today's quote, that look for something positive in each day. Every day is coming with something positive things. Even if some days you have to look a little harder. Not every day is the same, like not every fingers are same. If you see your fingers, you have a 5 fingers in one hand. So check this, your all fingers are not same. Same way, not all the days are coming with some positive things. Something positive you have to find in every day. Yes, even some days are coming which is not a good, which is not a positive, little harder for you. But you have to look something positive in that situation also. This one is a today's quote, and just deep lines is there and also a true lines are there. Just trying to understand it. Now we are in the chapter number 12, and the name of this chapter is a money. So as you know this thing that we always do revision before we start our lecture. So today also we do the same thing that we always doing revision first. So here also we are doing revision for the previous lecture also that we had done in the yesterday. So here is the revision. And please do revision students, because it is a very important things for you. If you are thinking that the videos are just a revision and something new, but revision is a compulsory for you all, and you have to do it, must do it, the revision. So let's do revision and then we are moving to the new topic, the textbook exercise. So here is the revision. So students, we are in the question number D now. So as per the instruction in the last lecture, in the previous lecture we do that. In the previous lecture we do this, that, we did this, that. We always see the instruction. So in the previous lecture, as I told you that, always read the instruction. So the instruction is that read the questions very carefully and understand it. So here we also read the question very carefully here. So here is the question number D. We are in the question number D. How much money must I carry? What is the question? Just read. I read it again for you students. How much money must I carry to purchase the pen and the bat? See here, the two pictures is given of the pen and a bat. So the question is, how much money must I carry to purchase the pen and bat shown in the picture? So here the two things shown here, right? So the question is, how much total money I must need to buy these two things? So let's see the price tag, right? Anything we buy. So what we should do actually, so before we buy anything, right, just focus on my words. Before we buy anything, we must check the price tag, right? We always check the price tag before we buy anything, at any time or any place it is, whether it is a clothes or it is a stationery, it means a book, pencils, erasers, right? Your bags, school bag, then a water bottle, whatever things you are using, right? So what you use for it, you use the thing for it, that what you use, the price tag, whenever you go to buy something, right? First we need to check the price tag, that if we have enough money or not to pay the bill, right? So here also let's check the price tag. So
So what is the price for the ball pen? The pen here, the written, the spelling of the pen is. So the price tag for the pen is rupees 47. What is the price for the pen? So the price for the pen is rupees 47. See this. Here I'm already written the rupees 47. You also should write this way, that the price of the pen is rupees 47 and the price for the bat is rupees 29. Okay. So now let's do a addition. What we should do? Let's should do a addition. Here I put the plus sign also. See, here is the price for the plus sign, right? We do addition. Let's add the numbers. So here is 7 plus 9. Let's do addition. Let's start addition with the ones value. So here is at the ones column 7 plus 9. We have to add the numbers in 7 plus 9. So students, 7 plus 9 is equal to how much? So let's add the number 7 plus 9. So how much it is? I'm giving you a 10 seconds and just you give me an answer that how much it is 7 plus 9. So 7 plus 9 is equal to 16. See, I am writing the answer here 16. 16. So from the 16, 6 is at the ones column. So I just write down 6 under the ones column. You can see this. I write 6 under the ones column and the another one will go for the as a carry forwarded number on the tens column. Here it is. You can see this, right? So now let's move to the tens column. So here is the column of tens. Now see this. 4 plus 2. So 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. So we have to add one more number in this 6. So 6 plus 1 is equal to 7. So what is the answer? 4 plus 2. So 4 plus 2 is equal to 6 plus 1 is equal to 7. So the correct answer is 76. How much money I need? I need a 76 rupees to pay the bill. So here the options is given. The option 1 is rupees 68. The option 2 is rupees 86. And the option 3 is rupees 76. So which option is the correct one? So the correct option is rupees 76. This one is the correct option. Now let's move to the question number E and also a last question. How much money would Meera need? Just read the question very carefully. How much money would Meera need to purchase the two toys? Let's read the question again because we have to understand it very well. How much money would Meera need to purchase the two toys shown in the picture? So the picture of the two toys is given here. You can see this, the two picture is given here. The one is a duck toy and the price of the duck toy is rupees 28. What is the price? The price for the duck toy is rupees 28 and the price for the toy is, you all are playing with this toy, the spinner. What, which toy it is? This is the spinner, right? And the price for it is rupees 55. What is the price for the spinner? So the price for the spinner is rupees 55. So I already written these two things, rupees 28 and 55. We have to add these two numbers. What we should do? We have to add these two numbers, rupees 28 plus rupees 55. So 8 plus 5 is equal to how much? We have to add rupees 5 into 8. So 8 plus 5. So we have to count 5 numbers after 8. So after 8, let's count more 5 numbers. 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. So students, 8 plus 5 is equal to 13. So I write 3 under the ones column. You can check this. 8 plus 5 is equal to 3. So I write down 3 there. And the one from the 13, I just move as a carry forwarded number on the tens column. What I should do? I just move the one number which is the carry forwarded number, and we have to add in the tens column. So now what is the tens column? 1 plus 2 plus 5. See this now, 1 plus 2 plus 5. So 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. How much it is together? 2 plus 1. So 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. Plus we have to add 5 into 3. So 5 plus 3 is equal to how much? So we have to add 5 numbers into 3. So let's count 5 numbers after 3. So how much it is? 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So the correct answer is 83. So how much money would Meera need? Here is the answer, that how much money she need to buy these two toys. So she need a rupees 83. See, these three options is given. The first option is rupees 55. The second option is rupees 83. And the third option is rupees 73. So how much money she need to pay the bill? So Meera would need a rupees 83 to buy these two things together. So these things you have to note down in the fair book, students.
Now here is the new worksheet of the money addition. Money addition. So let's see, first of all, if instruction is given or not. So yes, the instruction is given. Complete the following. So we have to do addition. We have to add the money. So rupees 10 plus rupees 2. You have to add the numbers. It means if you have a 10 rupees and more 2 rupees. So how many together it is? So it is a rupees 12. How much it is? If it is a 12 rupees and 2 rupees you have, so total it is together a 12 rupees. Now here is, if you have a 2 coins of 2 rupees, how much money you have? 2 coins of 2 rupees. So total you have rupees 4. Now you have a 15 rupees and 3 more rupees. So 15 plus 3 is equal to how much rupees? So 15 plus 3 is equal to 18 rupees. How much rupees it is? 15 plus 3 is equal to 18 rupees. Now if you have a 10 rupees and also a 1 more rupees, so total it is how much? 10 plus 1. So 10 plus 1 is equal to 11. How much it is? 10 plus 1 is equal to 11. Now here is 8 rupees and 8 rupees. So 8 plus 8 is equal to how much rupees together? So 8 plus 8 is equal to 16 rupees. How much rupees it is? 8 plus 8 is equal to 16. Now, if you have a 6 rupees and more 3 rupees your mother gave you. So how much money you have now? 6 plus 3. So students, 6 plus 3 is equal to 9. Total how much money you have? You have a 9 rupees. Now here is rupees 7 and 3 more rupees your friend gave you. So how much money you have together it is 7 plus 3. So 7 plus 3 is equal to 10. So how much money you have? 7 plus 3 is equal to 10. So you have 10 rupees. Now you have a 5 rupees and your father gives you more 4 rupees. So 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. So total you have how much money? So 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. So you have a 9 rupees. Now again 9 plus 9. You have already 9 rupees and your sister gives you a more 9 rupees. So total it is how much money? So it is a 18 rupees you have. How much money you have now? You have a 18 rupees. At the last you have a 12 rupees and your grandfather gives you more 12 rupees. So how much money you have now? Total it is a 24 rupees. So this is the money. Now see this students, here is your textbook exercise is this, and you have to write down this textbook exercise in the fair book. So as I told you before also, whenever you solve something, any exercise or any worksheet is there, so first of all check the instruction and the heading. So this one is adding money, this heading is given, this one your is the textbook page, this one is your textbook page, and the heading is adding money. What is the heading? Adding money. This one is a heading and the instruction is also given here, so we must follow the instruction. As I told you before also, whenever you try to solve any worksheets or any exercise, must follow the instruction, because it is some clues is there in the instruction that how we can solve the worksheet. This one is an exercise of your textbook. Find the total cost. We have to find out what is the total price of this given things. What we have to find? Find the total cost. This first one has been done for us. Then outline the money needed. Okay, so let's see this. Here the two things is given. One is a bat and one is a ball. You can check this. These two things is given in the picture and the price is also given with it. So you can check this, that what is the price for the bat, the cricket bat, right? You are playing the cricket in the vacation, you are most playing this game, the cricket. So here is the ball and bat is given. So the price for the bat is rupees 65. What is the price? 65. And the price for the ball is rupees 15. And you have this much money. A one note of rupees 50. One note of rupees 20 here, I zoom it so you can easily check this. One note of rupees 5050. One note of rupees 20. And three notes of rupees 10. You can check this. The three notes is given of rupees 10. So total it is how much money is there? How much money is this total? 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 100. Total it is 100 rupees. How much money it is you have? This much money you have in your pockets. So now how much money I should pay for these two things? How much money I have to pay if I buy these two things? So the price for the bat I written here 65. This is already done. The price for the bat is rupees 65 and the price for the ball is rupees 15. So here I am writing 15. To find out what is the total cost, here the word is given total, it means the addition, we have to add the numbers. So 5 plus 5 is equal to 10. So from the 10 I put 0 here and 1 is a carry forwarded number. 6 plus 1 is equal to 7 and 1 is a carry forwarded number is equal to 8. So what is the price? How much I have to pay for these two things? So I have to pay rupees 8080 to buy these two things. Now the next instruction is given that then outline the money that you needed. This much notes you have, so which notes you are using to pay the bill? What is the question? That this much notes you have, so which notes we are using to pay the bill? So we have to use a 50 rupees note. Which note I am using? I am using one note of rupees 50, one note of rupees 20. So it is a 70 rupees, one more note needed of rupees 10. So I just put circle the notes which I need to pay. A one note of rupees 50, one note of rupees 20 and one note of rupees 10. So this much money I need to pay the bill. Now next is a doll. Two dolls is given. So the price for the two different toy doll is given. So here the doll, the price of this doll is rupees 48 and the another toy's price is rupees 3030. What is the price exactly? The price for the first doll is rupees 48 and the price for the second doll is rupees 30. So let's write down first of all the numbers here. First of all, let's write a 48. This way you have to write down the first one. You also, if you have a textbook, so you can just find out this page and write down rupees 48. And the next price for the doll is rupees 30. What is the price for the doll? Rupees 3030. So I write here 3030. This way you also have to write down in the fair book. And in the textbook also, if you have, that is not compulsory, but if you have a textbook, so you can write it. Now to find out the total price for the both the things, if you want to buy these two things, that how much money you should pay. So let's do addition. So we should know that how much money we need to pay the bill. So always start addition with the ones value. So here is 8 plus 0 is equal to 8. Let's move to the tens column here. 4 plus 3. So let's count 3 numbers after 4. Start with the 5. 5, 6 and 7. So how much I have to pay for these two things? The total price for these two toy dolls is rupees 78. How much I have to pay? If you want to buy these two things, these two toys, you should pay rupees 78. Now the money is given, which you have, this much money you have. So which notes and coins we are using to pay the cost? My question is, which notes we are using to pay the bill? So let's use the note of rupees 50. Which notes we are using? Let's use this rupees 50 rupees note, one note. Then rupees a one note of rupees 20. It means this is a 70 rupees. So how much more money need? This is a 70 rupees, 70. 50 plus 20 is equal to 70. Now more 8 rupees we need to pay. So let's use a one coin of rupees 5. So it is a 75. One coin we are using of rupees 5, so it is a 75. Then let's use a one more coin of rupees 2 and one coin of rupee 1. This is now 78 rupees. Let's count if it is 78 rupees or not. 50, 20, it means a 70. Then a 5, it means 75, 77 and 78. So now it is a 78 rupees. Now the next toy. So the toy, drum toy is there. Two drum toy is there. So the first drum price is rupees 18. What is the price for the first toy here? So the first toy price is rupees 18 and the second, which is the drum. So the price for the drum is rupees 26. What is the price for it? So the price for the drum is rupees 26. You can check this. So let's write it 18 first. Here I am writing 18. You can check this. And the second toy price is rupees 26. So I write 26 here this way. You also have to write down this way and add the numbers. Now here is 8 plus 6. We have to start adding number with the ones column. With which column we have to start adding the number? We have to start adding the number with the ones column. 8 plus 6. So let's add 6 number into the 8 and start counting with the 9 number. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. So let's write 4 under the ones column, and the one number is moved as a carry forwarded number at the tens column. Now here is 1 plus 1 plus 2 is equal to 4. So how much the total cost for these two toys? So the total cost for these two toys is rupees 44. What is the total cost for these two toys? A rupees 44. So some money is given here. So which notes or coins we are using to pay 44 rupees? I repeat these things again, that which notes or coins we are using to pay rupees 44, because the total cost of these two toy together is rupees 44. So which notes or coins we are using here? So let's use one note of rupees 20. Which notes we are using? Let's use a one note of rupees 20. Then use another note of rupees 10. So it is a 30. It is a 20, then 10. So it is a 30 rupees. Then let's use our more two coins of rupees 5. 20, 30, and then more two coins of rupees 5. It means a more 10 rupees. So 20, 30 and 40. Now we need 4 more rupees. So let's use a 1 coin of rupees 2. So it is a 42. Now let's use a 1 more coin of rupees 1. So it is a 43. Let's use 1 more coin of rupee 1. So it is a now rupees 44. So which coins and notes we are using to pay rupees 44? A 1 note of rupees 20. One note of rupees 10, two coins of rupees 5, one coin of rupees 2, and there is a two coins of rupee 1. So these things we are using. Now here is at the last a color box and a water bottle. These two things is given. So what is the price for the color box? Rupees 27. The price for the color box is rupees 27 and the price for the water bottle is rupees 29. So let's add these numbers, 7 plus 9. So 7 plus 9 is equal to 16. So this way I write 6 under the ones column and 1 I can move as a carry forwarded number at the tens column. Now 1 plus 2 plus 2 is equal to 5. So how much money I have to pay to buy these two things? Rupees 56. So which notes we can use to pay 56 rupees? Let's use a one note of rupees 20, one more note of rupees 20, one more note of rupees 10. So it is a 50 rupees. More 6 rupees we want. So let's use a one coin of rupees 5 and one more coin of rupees 1. So it is a 56. Now see this, two notes we are using of rupees 20, one note of rupees 10, one coin of rupees 5 and one coin of rupees 1. So this way you have to write down this adding money textbook exercise in the fair book, and this is a very interesting exercise is this. So please do revision for this worksheet or exercise. Now, thank you so much students for watching this video. So please write down all the things in the fare book and also in the rough book, and if you have textbook, so please write down in the textbook also. Now stay home, stay safe. Thank you very much and have a nice day.